Who the fuck gets diamond shotguns and still uses the shotgun? Like, really? Seriously? that's like the worst thing I could think. Like, yeah, finally got diamond shotguns unlocked. What should I use this map? Let's use a shotgun. Man, he must really like them. I think they suck balls. The combat shot, the one he's using though, is the best of all of them. So I guess, you know, at least he's using the better of the shotguns. But God, I can't imagine wanting to use shotguns more after getting diamond on them. At least not by choice in S&D where all the sweaties play. We're using the Type 100. I wanted to use a gun that I loved during the beta. It was widely chosen as one of the best SMGs in the game. Unfortunately, it's not the beta anymore, and it was nerfed pretty heavily. Mainly because the damage range was just like destroyed, man. Oh, he's still there. This is gonna be really hard. How do I challenge guy? One AFK guy. And I'm thinking, how do I challenge a guy on a head glitch with a rifle with an SMG? Oh, I'm dead. Dive in. Got him. It's all good. Sit here for a moment. Try to block off anyone that could possibly see me. Let my teammates flank on him. There we go. One there. Down below me. Nothing. Yeah, baby. Juked him out. That was good. I loved this gun during the beta, man. I played it. If you guys watched me during the beta, it was a lot of Type 100 rapid fire grip. Although I didn't use Prime because that wasn't in the beta as much. I had three attachments, but it was rapid fire grip extended mags. I think I used infantry in the beta because that was available. And it was just domination on Gibraltar left and right. So, I mean, it was just my dominant head glitch SMG rifle combo. But in the beta, there was no bar, and I don't think there was an FG either. So you got to consider what I was going up against at the time. And there really wasn't a whole lot of competition. Shit. There was the PPSH. This gun was in the beta. It was pretty popular as well. I think what happened is when they nerfed the damage range, they made the guns that are rifle-like in terms of SMGs much shittier. And the guns that are more SMG-like, the PPSH, which I loved as well in the beta, the better overall SMG. So. Whoa, it's a new knife. I was wondering what the hell he was using. That's the, not the ice pick thingy, but the other one. I don't know what it's called. Interesting. I don't have that one unlocked yet. I'm working on the ice pick right now, so. Alright, we're up 4-1. Not bad, not bad. I have primed on an SMG. I feel like an idiot when I use this. It's just not a very good thing to use, typically. Let's throw this up, rile her. I don't see anybody in there. I could easily have mountain, though. Okay, sneaking in. No one on the corner. No one on the head glitch. Let's push through. Try to control the back of the map here if we can. We're gonna flash them out. Alright, they needed me. But I stunned one of their guys. Easy kill. Get down to the bunker. There we go. Position is nice and strong now. Unfortunately, our bomb guy is still on our spawn. He just died because, you know, naturally the guy that gets the bomb would have to be the guy that could never play the objective or get near it. Holy shit! The toggle action got beat by an SMG. Whoo, smokes. Yeah! Bring it on, motherfucker! I got you. Read him like a book at the Scholastic School Fair. One of the easy ones. Picture book, probably. 8-1. Not too shabby. I've been playing so much War, I'm like, dude, I gotta play some more S&D. And I know I wanna make S&D videos, because that's what you guys probably want to see, and what I like the most, but yesterday was a fun game of War. Don't ever give me shit, like, this isn't that good of a game on War. I'm not prolonging games of War with six-man teams to get 200 fucking kills, okay? Yeah, I can do that, but I wasn't doing that. There's a difference. Oh, man, that was through a wall, wasn't it? FMJ. That's why. That's fucking why. That makes more sense, at least. I'm not prolonging war games. I'm going for challenges with some of the worst fucking guns in the game. There's only four really good guns, okay? I call them the four deadly horsemen of the apocalypse. You got the SDG. You got the FG, the bar, the PPSH, and a sniper. And any sniper, pretty much, except the Carabin and Enfield. Those are the weaker ones of the snipers. But if you get hit by a Springfield or a Kar 98, you're fucking gone, right? Those are the four deadly horsemen of the apocalypse. If there is somebody using those four weapons in your game, they are trying, okay? 100% trying. Just keep track. If you think I'm lying, keep track of your deaths. Those four weapons are gonna be what's it, man. FG bar, PPSH, and sniper. And a lot of times, snipers are using both, they're using two of them. They're using a sniper and a PPSH, or a sniper and a bar, because rifleman is so damn easy to use. Very rarely are you going to see people use other guns. Unless they're doing camo challenges like me, or they're just trying other stuff out. Maybe they like the other gun. If you're playing hardcore, it's an exception. Type 100 is pretty damn good in hardcore. So is the Sten, I'm pretty sure. And some other guns are more easily available to use there. So I guess I'm referring to the four deadly horsemen in core, not hardcore. Got him. Oh, got him as well. Rip. Alrighty, get the reload in. Nicely done there. Teammates up top, that's okay. Whoever's using an SVT, I commend you, man. That was my fault. I will take blame for that. I 100% did not expect him to be in the window because I pushed up all the way and he didn't come and say hi to me. So I pretty much expected him to be somewhere else. Might be in a bad spot, but I'm gonna try it. I gotta go quick, because they're gonna flank behind me in 3 seconds here. Gotta get back up top. There we go. That was one flanking. Probably both are flanking, though, at this point. This late in the round, it's unlikely that just one is on the flank. It's possible. I just, you know, likeliness. Low, there we go, there we go, nice. He wasn't. He came back on his side. If it was that late in the round, I honestly expected one on the flank through bunker, one on the flank through the back tank there. Not a bad game. 13-2. Challenging some bars. They weren't all viewers in tryhard weapons. Thankfully, they're not all sweaties. Because otherwise, if they were, I don't think I would have won half the gunfights I did. There was a PPSH and a bar in there, but there was some toggle action. That's an SVT. Some people that are actually trying to have some fun with the game. So props to them. Props to them. They lost because of it, which is usual, to be honest. But props to them for it. It's nice to see people messing around. You guys really enjoyed the BO3 video the other day as well. So I'm going to do another BO3 video soon over the FFAR, which is what I wanted to do. I talked about it in the first one. But I didn't want to do it today. I wanted to do it another time. So not bad. 18K experience for a 5-minute match. I'm telling you guys, S&D, quickest way to level up if you're decent. Also, even better now because they fixed the match bonus glitch and they fixed the glitch with not giving double XP or XP bonuses properly because of the match bonus glitch. So, take advantage of it now. If you're a decent search player, man, level up. Level up. Go for it. Thank you guys for watching, though. I will see you next time. Short and sweet video. I love you, bros and broettes. If that makes sense. And that's it for me. Bye-bye.